What's up, everyone? Welcome back to One Strange Adventure, and welcome to the next video. This is a special one. We are talking to the mayor. Look at this semi. We are at Camp Margaritaville, beautiful place, and we're gonna actually have a video on this campground because we know you guys are gonna like this place. But while we're here, we are talking to the mayor of Margaritaville, and he owns this. Yeah, look at this semi, fully custom semi that he uses to tow his Grand Design Solitude, and he puts a Jeep on the back. Not a smart car, a Jeep. So we're gonna take a tour of this, we're gonna take a ride today. We're gonna show you all about it, so let's get going. We're actually gonna start kind of backwards. We're gonna start with the inside and take a ride on the inside. Then we're gonna come back and we're gonna take a look at the outside because there's some pretty cool tricks out here too. We're actually gonna take a ride in it now. So he's actually getting ready to pull it out. We're gonna get ready to go. I'm gonna hop in this thing and we're gonna take a ride. So check this out. All right, let's try that again.
Oh.
Ooh, Aero. Very nice. Now, what is this truck? Like, what year?
This is a 2012 Volvo VNL780.
Wow.
With the condo cab.
And, of course, like, the extended rear, which we're going to talk about in a little while, but that thing is so cool.
I didn't want to double tow anymore, and me and my wife were into the Jeep thing now, so instead of flat towing the Jeep behind the fifth wheel, as you'll see, we've extended the wheelbase of the Volvo to accept the Jeep and the Solitude fifth wheel.
I mean, just so cool looking, for sure.
I did my homework on this truck before I bought what they referred this truck to as a HDT.
Yeah.
A heavy duty truck for RVing. So I was gonna go out and purchase a new Ram truck and found out that it was like six figures and
yeah,
I'm not into paying over $100,000 for a pickup truck. So I have found that you can go out and do your homework on these HDTs and pick one of these up for under $100,000.
Wow.
And then
okay.
And then you can customize these things to whatever you want this truck to be. You can make it be.
And obviously never worry about payload again.
Never.
But yes. We're going to show you the guys the cabin when we get back. But for the moment, we're going to enjoy this ride.
And you notice my air shifter here? You might hear it shifting, but it's an automatic. It's a 12-speed automatic. And in the Volvo, this is your gear selector as it would be in a car. So you have reverse neutral drive, manual, and then you got your economy and power. And this one happens to be a 16 liter with in the neighborhood of 600 horsepower and 2,200 foot-pounds of torque.
Woo!
So it will go down the road.
Sure. No, this is cool. Thanks for taking me on a ride.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for taking all of these guys on a ride.
Yeah, enjoy it.
Yeah.
Other cool thing is this is like being in a Class A motorhome. The windshield in front of you is like
massive.
Watching a movie going by.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, it's massive and you can see traffic way up ahead of you. So if you know you got to slow down, you got a huge line of sight ahead of you. And these mirrors on the side, you can see forever behind you, and I can see all the way right down to the road outside my driver's door or your door. And they're heated, they're power windows, just like a pickup truck. Just amazing. And then I got mirrors up on the hood.
I could definitely see the benefit of using this to like cross the country. Now, what about campgrounds? Do you find that you aren't able to like stay in some campgrounds because of the whole rig?
Yeah, and I I went into this knowing that I'm going to box myself out of going into some campgrounds,
sure,
which I understand and I'm okay with. But in today's market, there are more and more campgrounds being built today that are new.
Massive.
That are massive and are able to house our style rigs.
Yeah.
Your fifth wheel, my fifth wheel. I might have to get a pull through where you can maybe get a back end. So, one awesome thing about this, and you'll see in the walk around, the fifth wheel hitch on this truck might be 36 feet back, but it's at the very back of this rig. And now the fifth wheel acts as a travel trailer for when you're backing up and you're turning pivot points. The pivot point is behind the rear axle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so it's almost like having a hitch back, a regular hitch back there.
It doesn't take as long for the fifth wheel to react when you turn. And with a Volvo, you have the greatest turning radius out of all the big rigs out there as far as turning your front wheel.
I was going to ask you, because it takes about three states to make a U-turn in my Ram 3500.
Yes. And that's what I had as a Ram. This thing, when it was, you know, a twin screw conventional looking semi, this, we did it at the resort. We went out in the parking lot. This thing turned nearly or just a little bit shorter than my Ram. It was incredible. And it has a refrigerator, two burner stove, food storage, clothing storage, and a rooftop tent on the top of the Jeep.
On the Jeep.
So we can go overlanding in that.
Not to mention, you have tanks in this truck that we're going to talk about in a little while when we see the exterior.
Yes. And we have 280 gallons of fuel on board. So we can go cross country and back. And one thing that I noticed, which we took it out for about a 150 mile ride the other day after we, you know, got the truck together, losing that one axle, I used to get about 7.5 to 8 miles to the gallon, whether I'm empty or towing. The other day, I got 9.5 to 9.8 miles to the gallon out of this truck, and that was on paper and on the computer. So dropping an axle increased the fuel mileage, and I had no idea that it would do that, but yeah. I'm pleasantly pleased.
I'm sure.
So now you figure 280 gallons times, let's say, on the short side, 9 miles to the gallon. That's a far distance.
That's a big distance. Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so we just got back to the campground, and now that we're stationary, we're going to take a look at the inside, the cabin, the camper. This thing, it might as well be its own RV. So we're going to talk to Rob. We're going to get to see some of the cool things that they've added and some of the stuff that already comes on the truck. This thing is awesome. So without further ado, let me turn around and get going on this cab. So your friend Steve there.
Yes, this is Skeleton Steve.
He looks like he's been there for a while.
Yeah, he's been hanging out. You know, it's like a built-in security system.
I think you need to feed him.
Yeah, well, that keto diet really did him in, but he's hanging out, right, Steve?
Tell me about this this place.
All right, so again, this model is a VNL 780, which is a condo cab, which is basically the biggest cab in, like, the semi-truck world. So with the Volvos, you have a huge wide cab area where you drive and your passenger area is. It's the widest. It's like a regular pickup truck wide. There's no little crawl space that you have to crawl into your sleeper, where this, you could, I mean, you're standing up, and if you can't even touch the ceiling in this.
No. But
here we have where you can sit for, eat dinner, sit here driving down the road. It's got seat belts and everything, just like a motorhome. We have the computer station where you can hook up to Wi-Fi in here, plug the laptop in. There's all sorts of, you know, lighting in here. It's got a killer stereo system in here. The windows behind me on either side to get more daylight in. There's storage underneath each dinette accessible to the outside, but check this. So when I'm driving, I get hungry or thirsty, obviously we're not traveling, but here you have a freezer, you know, just like your RV, if there's something in there that we have to cook. So we open up this and we have a microwave up top.
Lots of storage though.
Lots of storage, right? For, you know, looking from the outside in, you wouldn't think all this is here. And then you have nice drawers, and these are, I mean, the construction of this truck is amazing. You got more storage, top two shelves, storage across the whole front, and then you got driver accessibility storage, passenger. And then on this side, you have more storage. So here I got some winter stuff.
That's like a wardrobe.
Yeah. And then under that again, like right here, you got more storage. You got TP in there for the little cassette toilet. And then the TV is inside the fifth wheel, but there's a TV here that mounts on the mount, and you got cable with the antenna if you want. And then what's up? More storage.
Yeah.
And more storage.
Yeah. And you said that this has an AC back here as well, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like there's like a cab AC.
Yeah. So I lift this up, right? And this just goes like that. And now look, I mean, the square footage went up and double. But over here on this side, we got, here's the vents for it. And then behind you is the controls for the AC, stereo, alarm, you know, the truck alarm. We have an inverter in here, obviously, to run the, you know, 110 stuff. And then these windows, once I, you know, you pull these open, all of the sunlight comes in. You can roll them out to get fresh air as you're driving down the road. And there's AC ducts up here.
Wow.
And this is kind of cool. When you have this bed down, this goes like this, right? And looking in the floor, you have where this goes in the floor.
It becomes a ladder.
Yep. And this mounts on the side of the bed, and then you climb up this thing, and this thing is rock solid. And I'm told in the Volvos, you have a roll cage within the condo cab. So this is like a 5-star rated tractor, if you will. I have to say, this is a awesome riding vehicle.
I completely agree. Having just taken a ride in it, just the little distance that we did, I could definitely see how that would just be great across the country.
Yeah.
Very cool. All right. Thank you for the tour.
Thank you all for going on with us.
Let's take a look on the outside. Now that we have taken a look on the inside, Rob's gonna show us all the tricks and all the cool stuff about the outside. So we're just gonna do a walk around. We're gonna point out some things for you. I think this thing's probably got a little bit more than what you're even anticipating. So let's take a look at it.
All right, so we'll start at the front. Like when we were driving, I was telling you about these mirrors here on the hood. So basically these mirrors from the driver's seat, I got one on each side, and you can see stuff right here beside the wheel. So again, I refer back to safety. That's another, I think, safety item, that you're not going to run somebody out of their lane when you need to change the lane and you're 77 feet long. So safety. And then we have the big 22.5-inch tires. The brakes on this are massive. Here, let me show you this little gimmick here. So you have more storage. So under here, this is all pass-through storage, but I, you know, I got stuff stored here, like my air hose, 100 foot, and I'll show you on the back of the truck, we can hook up, being that the RV is only electric brakes and not air, so I still have the air back there that I can plug this hose in, run back, you know, top off the tires, whether it be on the trailer or the truck. I don't need an air compressor because the truck generates its own air.
I noticed you had an air
behind the seat.
Behind the seat.
Yeah, so, you know, it, some people use a brush to brush out the dirt, you know. You just
blow it out there.
Blow it out, clean.
Wow.
People ask you or make comments, boy, this thing's probably expensive to own and operate. No, it's not. Here's one of the fuel filters, and the other one is in this box. So there's two fuel filters, like $19.95 and $24.95. And I'll show you when I
pop. How much would that cost if it was the Ram?
I know, right? At 50,000 miles, I'm supposed to send the oil in to get it analyzed, and they'll say, you know, if it's clean, dirty, or indifferent. So at 50,000 miles, towing just this, I've been told they'll probably just say change an oil filter. At 50,000 miles, so when you're towing with your Ram, how often do you change your oil? 5 to 75?
5 to 70, yep.
So do the math of that, how many oil changes you got to do to get to 50,000 miles. I'm just cruising and I send a sample in at 50,000. So tires, once every 6 years. Brakes, I'm told I'll probably never replace the brakes because of the engine brake and I'm not towing any weight.
Right. So not compared to what this thing can tow.
Yeah, this was with the transmission, the gears, and this one has the D16. It's a 16 liter. So this, the tag is, I think, 100,000 pounds that this is designed to tow, which we've disrupted that because I took an axle away, extended it. So, you know.
You're still good with 20,000 pounds.
Yeah, I think overkill, but not overkill.
I think you'll be okay.
So here's the bed that we had custom made. This is, again, overkill for the construction. I mean, this is like rock solid. There's different tie downs. I can put my 39 Chevy up here if we go to car shows, like up in Pigeon Forge or whatever. Or the Jeep can go up here. And we got the drum box to build and the handle to come out. So I have a handle to get up. You saw this. All these little custom things. This piece of steel was handmade, cut, bent to, you know, give it a nice little effect around the little fender skirt here. We have where this has got a 70 or 75 gallon black tank, and on the other side I have a 75 gallon freshwater tank. So when we go boondocking and stuff like that, when the L pooper tank is full, we can pump it to this tank, and when I need more water, I can take the freshwater, pump it to the Solitude.
Take this and go dump.
Yep. And I use the truck as a transfer.
Fill it back up.
Yeah, and the camper can just sit where it's at. And then the Jeep, like I said, that I turned that into an overlander, so it's got a stove, refrigerator, clothes storage, food storage, and then the rooftop tent. So we can go anywhere on the trails with the Jeep. And then this bad boy, this hitch is amazing. This is rated up to 36,000 pounds. So this thing, I mean, you can see how easy that rocks. The front to back is operated by here. You have two airbags underneath this hitch along with shock absorbers. So not only is the truck on air, your hitch is on air, and then we have the Moride hitch pin box.
And I see you've done some modifying there.
Yeah, because
it's lower.
Yeah, because I put the hitch in the frame instead of on the frame. So now I can drive the 39 or the Jeep over this and get it up with no problem. So we just had to drop the pin box down 8 inches, and this thing is a quarter inch off front to back on the level road. So Jesse did a freaking awesome job once again. And who built this was Jesse from Hall Fabrications. You know, you see these HDTs where they have smart cars and they got the ramps stored under the bed, and you gotta pull them out, unfold them, hook them on, and drive the car off. I didn't want any of that, I wanted this. So when the metal door hits, we got little rubber bumpers so nothing gets messed up. And then these ramps come out. He made these too, it's all aluminum. So these pull out, and then I just drive the Jeep down. These are 6 foot long at a 25 degree angle, which is no big deal. And then these just go, they slide in, this locks, and this is my deal. So these lights are the same exact lights that are on my Jeep. So they match. And then you say, well, where do you store all the straps to hold the car Jeep down? So we have built-in storage right there that we keep all the straps and everything nice and dry and tidy.
You guys thought of everything.
Yeah, and then this is a 35,000 pound receiver hitch that it has an adapter to go in here to hold the receiver, and it's a massive receiver in the truck. So whatever you want to tow that weighs 35,000 or less off the back ball. And what we were talking about, you know, going down the road, pulling this through a city or tight campgrounds and stuff like that. Yes, this is long. It's 37 foot long. It's got 300-inch wheelbase. So you say, man, that's a sucker to turn, right?
That's an RV by itself.
Right. Yeah, it's like a motorhome, right?
Yep.
So I say that to talk about this hitch and its location. So this hitch is mounted all the way to the rear of the truck. So basically with that pin back here, when you go to turn, the reaction time is of a travel trailer. So this basically, you back it up like a travel trailer because of the pivot point is behind the axle, which makes this whole thing, because the fifth wheel, it's 44 feet long, right? So when you turn, the pivot point reaction time is a whole bunch quicker than your conventional fifth wheel up over the axle, where it has to pivot over the axle. So that back here makes it a lot more enjoyable to back this beast into your conventional RV side.
All right, so that's the outside. There's one more part of the outside that we have to take a look at. Let's pop the hood.
With one or two little fingers, watch this. It's that easy. One finger lifts the hood. And now you see this 16-liter Volvo engine that is just a beast.
All right, guys, well, that wraps up taking a look at the Volvo. This thing is amazing. Like, if you're out there, you're thinking about ordering a truck, like he was saying, six figures for these Rams, for these Fords, Chevys, GMC, all those, and you could be getting this thing, which is, you know, equivalent to like six of those trucks. So.
Yeah. For less than a brand new, you know, dually.
Right, right.
Put a name on it, but well, it'd be less.
Rob, I really appreciate you giving the tour. Yes. Inside out. The ride was awesome. And just appreciate it, man.
All
it's
right.
It's pretty
cool.
Hope
y'all enjoyed it, and everybody out there, safe travels.
Yep. All right, guys, if you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you really like it, make sure you subscribe. And until the next strange adventure, keep making your own. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching today's video, and a special thank you to our Patreons listed right over here.
Yes, without you guys, we could not do this. If you have not considered joining yet, please do. Links down below.
And our next video is recommended right below this one, so go check that out.